Hello guys, and welcome to JavaFX for beginners from Genius Coders. In this video, we'll start the libraries. First, start the JFoenix library. The purpose of using the library is to add the attractiveness in your software, so your software will look good or make an impression on your customer also. So let's talk about the libraries of JavaFX. So when we use search on some JavaFX libraries, there are different libraries like see other, meet layout, VJS, styles effects, stage text effects, control effects. We will see these libraries later. So in this video, we will talk about the JFoenix library. So JFoenix library is a library which used for the in JFoenix. There are different components look good and feel. So when we go to our jfoenix.com, the official site, you can see the UI looking great. The JFoenix material design library. This is a material design library which help us to build a material design. So let's get started and see. You can see the documentation. If you want to find the code, you can find here the checkbox, buttons. So in JFoenix, the components start from the JFX and component name. Means if you have the JFoenix component, so its name like JFX button, JFX checkbox, like this. So let's download this jar file, JFoenix.jar file. So we'll go to the GitHub library. Go to the GitHub website and you can see the JFoenix, it's open source, so you can find the source code from here also. And you can see the JFoenix for Java 9 for it and also for Android. So now I have the Java 8, so I will download the Java 8 JFoenix jar for Java 8. So download this, save. So after downloading the JFoenix jar file, open your SceneBuilder, and for use of JFoenix controls, we need to add the JFoenix.jar file in your SceneBuilder. So open this and go to the setting icon, small setting icon. Near the search bar, setting, click on the icon. Now go to the jar/fx manager. Now there are some actions. So add library/fxml from file system. Click on this. So go to your jfoenix.jar file path. Go to the path jfoenix.jar. Let's open the jfoenix.jar file and open this. After opening its process or check how many components are in .jar file. It's processing. Now you can see the 36 items in our JFoenix. So there are different components or some new components are available on JFoenix. You can see the JFX badges, dialog, or we can say node list, pop-up, progress bar, spinner. Okay, so notice that all are the checkable, and import the component. So it's added. We close this. There is a one section is added named custom. In custom, there are all JFoenix components are available. So let's see some difference with JFoenix and some default component. So I will open the XML file. So we can see some default components which we have seen in previous videos, and this is a JFoenix components which have really more material design are available in JFoenix. So you press the Ctrl T and see the preview of this XML. So this is the text field of JFoenix, and this is the default text field of components of JavaFX. Then type here, and this is the text area of JFoenix. And see the differences of JFoenix and default components. This is the button, simple button, toggle button are available, radio button, color picker, choose the color any. This is the combo box, checkbox, progress bar, this is progress bar, and this is spinner. So this is the differences. This is the progress bar. So this is the basic differences of JFoenix components and default components. It's very look like great. So I recommended you. So if you develop some software, you should try this because it's really like good for your software also. So in next video we will see some basic components of JFoenix, like JFX text field and JFX password field. So let's see how we can code for this also. So see you in next video, guys.